And that's with ARC in terms of quality systems and science. That's with HRSA in terms of manpower and capacity building. That's with CDC in terms of community public health infrastructure. That's with Office of National Coordinator on the establishment of the infrastructure for electronic health records. And so as an organization that is projected to have as many as 70% of Americans eventually, either in Medicaid or Medicare, we have to begin to look upstream at the cost drivers for the future. What changed with the Affordable Care Act is the potential for most Americans to have access to health care, to have access to health care coverage. But to keep health care coverage affordable, everything is linked. If Medicaid is transferring costs into the commercial market, it raises health care costs. If the commercial market is unable to provide coverage to individuals, by the time they become Medicare eligible, they have all this pinned up demand because they haven't been provided adequate care. And so we're now all linked, and we're going to have to act that way. And so we're reaching out to the commercial health plans and saying, let's look at this together, especially as it relates to population health issues, raising the capacity of communities, really focusing on decreasing healthcare disparities, dealing with chronic care management processes where there's continuity across the system and that each provider is appropriately helping to manage chronically ill patients. And that means breaking down some of the unfortunate silos that have occurred between personal health and behavioral health, between acute care and prevention, between hospital care and outpatient care. And then finally, to improve community health status. And what that means is we have to realize that a lot of the social, economic, and healthcare determinants of our costs start with in the community. When I was in Arizona, one of the studies we did was, where was most of our healthcare costs coming from? And we began to realize there were approximately 20 census tracts, or zip codes rather, in Arizona that generated 40% of our costs. And if you looked at the social economic factors, these were, of course, low in terms of low economics, but these were communities that had higher drug abuse, higher, besides substance abuse, domestic abuse. You had greater individuals incarcerated. And so when you look at that and then you see a dropout rate in high schools that's up to as high as 35 to 40%, and you begin to realize all we're doing is generating these high-risk individuals who eventually will want healthcare services. And so we have to go upstream and begin to build capacity in the communities and use medical homes at primary care networks, ACOs, accountable care organizations, as part of the strategy to build community capacity. So simply stated, and this is what Don made very clear to us, was, look, he was one of the authors in the the IOM's treatise on the quality chasm. And they came up with these particular characteristics of the chasm. Patient safety, effectiveness of the healthcare delivery system, patient-centeredness, timeliness, efficiency, and equity. And he said, that's what I want us to focus on. That's going to be the hallmark of what our job is going to be, and the legacy that we're going to leave is that we're going to begin to address these issues. So when we talk about a transformed system, the first thing we have to recognize is that there's some strategic focus areas that we're going to have to address. And one of them, of course, is going to be addressing the whole issue of meaningful use of electronic health records. And one of the unfortunate things that happened was in the effort of Congress to provide funding for electronic health records, they left a lot of nursing homes out. They left nursing home facilities out of that effort. And you're in a very important part, as well as home and community-based services, as well as home health organizations, and we're going to have to find a way to connect the long-term care industry into electronic health records. Why is that important to us? Because we believe that cost containment cannot be done unless you have transparency into where the costs are, where the opportunities to reduce costs are. If you bring people into the room and you show them the data, they're usually able to show you where they can reduce the costs. Unfortunately, most people say, we don't have the data. And so one of the things that CMS is doing is looking at how we can be a data contributor to those organizations that want to work collaboratively with us to help control costs and improve quality. And so as we think of the transformed system, driving quality improvement is going to be very important. And as I mentioned, we're not trying to do this in a way that more regulation, but trying to establish organizations that are organically aligned to these strategic focus areas with us. That means we're going to have to be a participant in reducing and making our systems more administratively simple and more user-friendly. We're going to have to use the technology tools that are available to us to really make it easier to work with us. And this is part of our effort in terms of excellence in operation, is that the people who we rely on, our partners, the providers, will find us easier to work with in the future. So if we think about the delivery system transformation as a set of steps, what are the barriers? I mentioned one of them, which is the lack of information technology where the exchange of information can help virtually coordinate care, to give the point of care information. And so this structural barrier has to be overcome if we're going to move from an episodic, non-coordinated system into an accountable system that manages performance, manages to metrics. You can't hold a physician accountable for managing a population or a patient if they can't see where that patient's going, if they have no view of the fact that that patient was in the hospital or in the emergency department. And so the unfortunate thing, I think the litmus test, is when a physician has to ask the patient, you were in the emergency room, what happened, what did they do, what did they say to you? And so the patient has to be educated enough to say, well, they put me on this medication, I was diagnosed with this, they monitored me this way, here's my diagnostic readout. Well, that's just not going to happen. And so accountable healthcare requires us to overcome that technology infrastructure barrier. And that means in order for the nursing home industry and the home health industry and the long-term care programs to be involved in it, you're going to have to work to overcome that technology barrier so that we are linked and integrated